Performance analysis of solar water heater for space heating in residential and commercial buildings. Introduction. Solar energy is an exhausted energy resource to promote the development of energy policies. One of the solar technologies that are currently used are solar thermal collectors. The fundamental objective of an air collector is to absorb as much radiation as possible to convert it into thermal energy. Solar collectors have various uses. Among the most common are water heating, space heating, and industrial processes. In solar collectors, different factors must be considered, such as the optimal angle of inclination, the cloud thickness, albedo, shadow size. These are variables that differently affect the system's performance. The cost analysis in the thermal efficiency influences the implementation of solar collection system, which involves the evaluation of various criteria in the configuration and the setup of collector. When comparing the single pass air heating collector with a double pass collector, the thermal efficiency of double pass solar air heating collector is 10% higher, while in the double pass collector system with an absorber matrix is the 25% higher than that of the collector without a matrix. There are different designs and models of solar collector, but the most used is the flat type with an average efficiency of 40 to 60% and operation temperature between 50 and 200 degrees. And the application of a solar collector for the dual use of air and water heating has been studied by several researchers. The approaches that taken are based on modifying existing equipment or testing a new design. Dual heating has been sought to be more efficient than single purpose heating. This article investigates the technical feasibility of using solar water heating collector, the air heating application for space conditioning. The present study does not seek dual or single operation of a solar collector by modifying an existing design or developing a new one, but rather the direct use of liquid solar collector for air heating application. The aim of this investigation is to use the equipment to optimize energy resources, obtaining valuable results for future application in air heating and ventilation. Experimental setup. The equipment used in the investigation is a flat plate solar collector that was a part of a water heating system. The water circulates through channels that are part of the absorber plate, just reduction resistance. The experimental setup consists of a flat plate collector, blower, two types of thermocouples, water station with a pyranometer and temperature sensors. Mathematical model. This is the mathematical model uses energy output of the collector. Figures show a diagram of the analysis flat plate solar collector whose principle of operation is based on the fact that the absorber plate has high solar absorbity and low emissivity, being capable of taking the greatest amount of energy from the absorber, and that the cover is capable of preventing radiative and convective losses. This is the mean absorber plate temperature, mass flow rate, and the collector efficiency. Experimental results tests were carried out during 12 days. The variable measures were inlet and outlet air temperature, ambient temperature, and total solar radiation. Experimental results, ambient temperature and solar radiation. The experiment was developed at the Miguel de Cervantes campus University located in the city of Quito. Due to the ability, the collector tests were carried out only for 2 days. The diagram exposed the solar radiation between these hours. Overall result, experimental results with the efficiency. Ambient temperature, inlet, outlet air temperature. The trend of inlet temperature is observed in figure are even present variation of 1 degree at most, due to the forces convection that exists by the instrument used, the blower, to provide air to the interior. When this activity happens, the air hits the blade of the dynamic machine of the instrument, creating friction in the same between the fluids and the internal walls of the equipment. So its temperature increases, while the output temperature varies considerably in the ratio of 5 to 1, like the other temperatures when passing through the solar thermal collector. Outlet air temperature versus solar radiation. The curves shown in the figures detail the variation over the time of the output temperature with respect to the solar irradiation, presenting a directly proportional and homogeneous distribution in each location according to the range of the established hour. There is a maximum output temperature of 94 degrees and a radiance of 810, a minimum output temperature of 34.6 and irradiance of 298. Collector efficiency curves. The values can be better appreciated in the figure, which present a simple set of linear efficiency data. The dispersion of points present are linear, so a linear trend is applied to show the efficiency increase of constant fluid rate. Conclusion is what determines that it's possible to directly and efficiently apply the flat plate solar water collector as an and heater for space condition. The global efficiency of the collector was 59. The performance of the solar collector was very satisfactory, considering that it was designed for water heater and did not have any modification. Thank you.